Bask, and a lot of pet owners are concerned that their pets literally have bad breath. And is there anything you can do to prevent it, or at least make it a little bit better?
Mm-hmm. Sure. Well, most of the time when a dog or even a cat has bad breath, it usually means we have some form of dental disease. You can imagine, heaven forbid, you and I go all the time without brushing your teeth. You can imagine what it looks like. Well, it's the same thing with dogs and cats. It could start early. There is a genetic aspect to it, in which case some dogs have worse teeth than others. Some need to have their teeth cleaned more than others. So they both happen. The way we try to minimize it, number one, when they are warranted and they do have dental disease, we like to do scaling and polishing here in the office, a professional scaling and polishing. That will help minimize tartar accumulation, plaque formation. We also offer now, interesting enough, we do have something called a non-anesthesia teeth cleaning, because a lot of people have anxiety about the anesthetic, which is very, very safe. All the drugs that we use are the newest and the safest and the best, but we do have people that are concerned, so they hold off, goes longer and longer, it's worse and worse, and then you get a lot of issues as a result. So we're offering something called a non-anesthesia teeth cleaning, and not everybody's meant for that, but it's a wonderful way of doing teeth that are very mild to moderate dental disease, and it's very safe, it's very quick, and it's also relatively inexpensive. Diet is important. Most of the time with dogs, we like to use hard crunchies. Breaks down some of this calculus. With cats, it's interesting, that used to be the case, but now with cats, we actually recommend more canned food because of the benefit. It's not the same. The cats don't drink a lot, so we need more moisture. So we don't get a lot of teeth issues that the dry will benefit. So in cats, canned food is actually better. Dogs, dry food is better. So putting on the proper diet, making sure that we're having regular checkups, getting the teeth cleaned periodically as needed, depending on the patient, you know, could be more than once or twice a year, but it really just depends, and that's the best way of preventing.
Thank you.